What is going on, everybody? Estas here. Welcome back to another video. So in this video, we're going to be doing an overall market update, taking a look at the Dow Jones, the S&P 500, and the NASDAQ. We're going to be doing a quick, brief trading update today, although not much movement was in my portfolio, but we're still going to be talking about that. And we're also going to be diving into Apple's earnings today. I have a bunch of notes here on my phone talking about some key numbers and metrics from the earnings. And for those of you guys that have been watching the stock after hours, it's going absolutely bananas, guys. So before we get into that, for everybody out there that finds value in these videos, you enjoy the content that I'm putting up here on YouTube, feel free to go down below and hit that like button. It really supports me and supports the channel in general. And honestly, it's telling me that I'm doing a good job and for me to continue to create content here for you guys. So without further ado, guys, let's just jump right into it. I don't want to waste too much time in today's video. Let's quickly do the rundown on what the overall markets are looking like, the S&P, the Dow, and the NASDAQ. We can see here the SPX, also known as the S&P 500, the 500 largest publicly traded U.S. companies, ended up closing the day up $2.80, up 0.1%. Nothing crazy, but if we hop in here on the 1 day, 1 minute, we can see it did tank really early today. If this does want to load, okay, there it is, guys. We saw the big gap down all the way to 29.24, but we've recovered very nicely from that low point, about a 21-point swing. We'll talk about that a little bit more in depth in a couple of minutes here. The Dow Jones Industrial Average, same thing, guys. Big gap down to 26,400. We hit that support level. We popped up nearly 200 points from there. Ended up closing the day up $38.52, up 0.15%. So the NASDAQ, I'm assuming it's doing very well here after hours. Yup, it is, because Apple is going up like crazy. But overall, we're up $37.75 as of right now, up about 0.48%, nearly half a percent in terms of the NASDAQ. So let's hop back over to the S&P 500, guys, and we're going to look at some technicals here that are affirming to me that the uptrend is continuing in the S&P 500, and we can simply see it here on the 20-day, one-hour chart, right? We saw how we took that pretty big gap down today to about 29.20, which was about nearly 30 points lower from the all-time high we hit yesterday of about 29.49, but we maintained a higher low from the previous, which is the continuation of the uptrend on one technical aspect, and the second one is we held the 50 simple moving average support, which has been a support over the past couple of weeks on this 20-day, one-hour chart, which is a very, very good sign. And to be quite honest with you guys, if Apple holds the levels that they are at right now, if the stock maintains roughly the 210, 215 level tomorrow, you know, this, in my opinion, is going to push up the SPX, and we're going to have a pretty big green day. Not maybe the biggest green day, but we're probably going to push to another higher high and probably to another all-time high into the 2950s, maybe 2960s, if Apple does end up maintaining these levels and popping up the market tomorrow. But all in all, guys, not much to break down, right? We're simply really testing all-time highs again. The uptrend is still intact, and we confirmed it on the 20-day, one-hour chart that it is still intact. So hopping over here to the Dow Jones, we talked about and we've been talking about on these videos how the Dow has been maintaining this horizontal channel from 26,400 up to 26,800, this 400-point buffer range. That's where we've been trading in terms of the Dow over the past couple of weeks. And if we see here on the 20-day, 1 hour, we can see exactly what I'm talking about. Actually, let's go to the 30-day, 90 minute. We can see it a bit better, right? We've been trading pretty much from the middle of April to now. So pretty much half of this month of April, we've been trading within this range. We pulled back again, like we saw earlier today in the Dow Jones, pretty sizable pullback. And the confirmation of the uptrend, just like the SPX, is, or it has rather been confirmed on the 20-day 1-hour since we held a higher low from the previous. We're pushing up to make a higher high from the previous here at about 26,600. Hopefully, if the markets go up tomorrow, that will end up happening. And that's pretty much it, right? The uptrend is intact. Everything is looking solid right now for the Dow Jones. And just like I've been saying in these videos, guys, we need to see a breakout of 26,800. Roughly 200 points higher from where we are right now for the Dow Jones to test all-time highs. And in my opinion, this is something that can very well happen in the next couple of weeks if the markets continue to stay strong. So that's the overall update, guys. Nothing crazy in terms of a green day here, but the uptrend, again, is still intact, just like the SPX. We're looking to break all-time highs here in the Dow in these next couple of weeks. So the NASDAQ, like I said, it's popping up mostly to a good earnings report to, in terms of Apple here. We're bouncing on the 50 simple moving average on the 184-hour chart. Very good sign that this was kind of like a bullish little pennant here in a way, right? We can see it was, if I can get my little drawing tool, actually, I could probably just do it like this, right? We can see it was kind of downtrending a bit, right? If we can actually get it, right? It was kind of doing something like that. And the fact that we bounced here on the 50 is a very good sign that we want to continue to push up here. But now what I want to see is a break out of this little downwards trending resistance of the channel that we can see here very clearly from my trend line. If we break that tomorrow, guys, which it seems like we already are, and again, if the markets do well tomorrow, this is most likely going to happen. That's going to be a breakout in the NASDAQ, and I wouldn't be surprised if we were to hit another all-time high, you know, past 78.79, maybe into the $7,900 level if that does end up happening. So honestly, you know, over these past couple of videos, there hasn't been much to really go over in terms of the markets, right? They've been in the same levels, right? They've been really maintaining the same patterns, and that really just instills, or really it's just maintaining, or really the patterns are the same in today's video, right? Very similar to what I talked about yesterday. The uptrends are still intact. That's all I'm really seeing right now, guys. So let me know down below in the comment section, what are your opinions in terms of the market right now? Obviously, the markets have been going absolutely crazy, right? We're up 20, 30, 40, 50% in some of these stocks that hit lows towards the end of 2018 and beginning of 2019. I would love to know, are you guys buying stocks right now? Or are you guys just simply mostly in cash? Are you waiting for a big pullback to hop back into stocks? I would love to know. Just let me know down below in the comment section. So what are we doing, or what did I do rather, in terms of my trading today? Honestly, guys, I didn't really do much of anything new, right? You know that I'm in Facebook and Procter & Gamble, which both did pretty decent today. Facebook had a run up to $198 nearly today, right? We saw that. But it honestly took a little pullback from there and actually hit all the way to the 192 level. Very volatile day here in terms of Facebook. I did not add to the position due to the massive spike that we saw here. I kind of thought that we were going to see a bit of a pullback here. I didn't think it was going to be this aggressive, but I didn't want to add money here and then pull back, right, and kind of get faked out. So I'm still just simply holding my Facebook shares roughly in the 193 level where I initially bought a couple of days ago. So that's kind of the rundown here on Facebook. I'm still very confident in this swing trade. I still plan on holding this one into the 200 plus level. That is the plan as of right now. Procter & Gamble did very well for me today. This is another one of those swing plays that I'm currently in. I bought in after their earnings report. This one was up $1.70 today, up 1.62%. And we were talking about in yesterday's video how the pullback that we saw yesterday was not surprising to me, right? Because we saw a very big pop-up on Friday. I believe it was a 2.5% day from 103 all the way up to 106 in after hours. So this pullback was simply a little bit of a retracement, right? We still maintained the trend here on the overall 5-day, 5-minute chart. And you can see literally the trend line that I drew in yesterday's video. Take a look at that, guys. I promise I didn't touch that trend line. This is literally what I drew yesterday. And take a look at how perfectly it played off of that trend line, right? If we just extend it a bit, it's not going to be perfect, but you guys get the idea here. It literally bounced right at the support of that trend line from the pullback yesterday, and it popped up super aggressively, and that was the bounce zone, right? From 104.50-ish, higher low from the previous, we pushed to a higher high now. So tomorrow, we might see another bit of a pullback, or we might just pop up into the 107 level. That is what I'm looking for in terms of Procter and Gamble. So to be quite frank with you all, that's all I did today in terms of trading, right? I didn't really deploy any new money into the stock market. I didn't take any day trades. I'm just waiting, or rather, I was waiting to see what AMD was going to do and what Apple was going to do so I can maybe deploy some cash into those in tomorrow's session or maybe in the rest of this week. And I actually have a lot of other stocks that I'm eyeing up, right? I'm eyeing up a position in Ford. I'm just waiting for the right entry point. I'm eyeing up a position in Google, believe it or not. Once this, you know, earnings, they missed in terms of earnings, the stock went down a lot. I want to wait and see if there's going to be a reversal to the upside on Google for potential swing play. So I didn't really want to force any trades today, if that makes any sense. And sometimes, guys, I haven't talked about this in pretty much a couple weeks at this point. Sometimes the best trade to make in the stock market is no trade at all, right? Sometimes it's best to just sit on some cash and wait on some opportunities, right? So tomorrow, there's most likely going to be a lot more movement in my portfolio. And let's just talk about Apple now, guys. You saw it in the title. I'm sure you clicked about on this video to hear about Apple's earnings. Let's just talk about it and see what the stock is doing right now. I actually haven't checked it in a couple of minutes here, so it seems like we are at about $211.31 as of right now. We popped up all the way to 213. So typically when you're seeing a stock move like this on earnings, you better believe a 90% chance that the earnings were good, right? So let me just pull up my notes here. I have a bunch of notes about Apple's brief numbers, right? So let's just do the rundown, guys. Earnings per share came in at $2.46 per share. That beat the 237 expected by analysts. So beat on EPS, very, very good metric there. Revenue came in at $58.02 billion versus $57.49 billion expected, another beat on revenue. So the two key metrics we're looking at for earnings, right? EPS, revenue, Apple beat on both of those. I believe their EPS beat by 4%. Don't quote me on that. And their revenue, not as big of a beat in terms of EPS. I believe it was like 1%, 2%. Again, don't quote me on that. This is just off the head numbers based on what I'm seeing here. If we're going down to iPhone sales, guys, iPhone sales has been one of the key controversies in this business, right? The iPhone sales have been weakening. China demand has been weakening. Sales in China have been weakening over the past couple of months. So iPhone sales actually came a bit short. They came in at $31.05 billion versus $31.1 billion expected. They're actually down from $38.03 billion from last year's quarter. That is roughly a 17% drop, which is actually the biggest drop in history, guys. So that's pretty huge in terms of the iPhone sales. A couple of months ago, guys, I just kind of briefly mentioned that. A couple of months ago, Apple announced its weakening sales in iPhones in the Chinese market, which comprises the Chinese market, that is, one-fifth of the total sales from 2018. So you can understand that if a certain area, if a certain market comprises one-fifth of your business and that market is being, or doing poorly rather, that's going to have an effect on the business, right? So China sales dropped 26.7% in the first quarter of 2019. And we talked about the weak Chinese demand, right? So Apple cut prices of the iPhones in China to stimulate more demand, right? Which seems to be working with the sales in China starting to stabilize. So I'm actually very happy to see that as an investor, as a long-term believer and shareholder of Apple. Again, the Chinese market is a huge market for Apple, guys, and we need to see China start to stabilize, start to grow in terms of sales again for the overall business to continue to flourish and grow. So the fact that it is starting to stabilize there in terms of Apple's biggest product, which just happens to be this device you're seeing, the iPhone, right? That makes me super happy. So we didn't only beat on EPS and revenue. Some of the smaller segments of the business, including services and wearables, they also did significantly better than the expectations, especially wearables, guys. Services beat. It wasn't a crazy beat, but it was a beat. They came in at $11.45 billion versus the $11.32 billion expected, which is absolutely great, right? They beat on the services, which is one of the businesses they're looking to expand, right? We saw the new news service, right? The streaming service, the gaming service, the one other service, the fourth one. I can't remember off the top of my head, guys. I seem to always forget one of the four, new segments they're coming out with, but they're really trying to take the iPhone database, which is around 1 billion, registered iPhones from what I believe. And they're really trying to expand that into different models, including the services, the services business, because this is going to be a cash cow for the business in the next coming years, in my personal opinion. So the wearables revenue came in at $5.13 billion versus $4.79 billion expected. Another big thing, guys, the board has authorized another $75 billion in share repurchases, which is very great news. And for you dividend investors out there, you dividend growth investors, you investors that believe Apple is going to be a big dividend payer in the future, which I personally believe as well, they raised their dividend by 5%, guys. This is very, very, very big news, because people that invest in dividend paying companies, they not only like to see, a strong starting yield, they like to see businesses that are growing their yield year over year very, very aggressively. So 5% growth in a quarter, if they keep it at this rate, that's going to translate to a 20% growth in the dividend yield over a year, which is a very, very strong dividend growth in terms of a company like Apple, right? So that's just the rundown of their earnings for ticker symbol AAPL. Drop a comment down below. Let me know what you guys think about this. I would love to know. I know a bunch of you in the group chat were actually holding Apple. You had some call options, whatever the case may be. So if you did very well on Apple, congrats to you. I hope it does maintain these levels, and I hope you guys are able to take your profits tomorrow. Hopefully, Apple doesn't pull a Facebook, and by that I mean when Facebook reported earnings a week or two ago, whenever that ended up happening, the stock popped up heavily. Then we saw a very big pullback on the next day. To be quite frank, I personally wouldn't mind that, because I don't have a swing position in Apple right now. So if we did pull back, I'd probably add some shares in my swing account for Apple on a positive earnings report. That's just my style, right? I typically wait until after earnings to see what the guidance is, what the earnings are, were they positive, were they negative, and from there I like to get in on pullbacks. That's kind of what I do here, in terms of one of my strategies. So Apple, that's what they ended up doing. AMD, I'm not going to go too in-depth on their earnings because, quite frankly, guys, I don't want this video to be 45 minutes long. So let's just go to their live news very quickly. I know they did quite well. Let's just see what they ended up doing in terms of revenue or their earnings. So if we go down here, hopefully they do have it. Here it is, guys. They had EPS of 0.06, which beat the 0.05 estimate. I believe that was a 20% beat on EPS, which is absolutely amazing, right? Remember, AMD is a smaller cap company, guys, so that's why the earnings are very in the pennies, right? It's a small cap company. The sales came in at $1.27 billion, which beats the $1.26 billion estimate. So that, in terms of the brief metrics on AMD, is a good earnings report. So let's just start off with AMD in terms of a technical breakdown, right? We've been talking about AMD in this range that it's been in from $27 to $28. And I was talking about in yesterday's video, the past couple of videos, how when AMD was going to report earnings, it was either going to break to the upside, right? The upside of that channel above $28, or it was going to sell off into the $26 level. So what we're seeing now is finally some direction on AMD. We're breaking out of this resistance. We hit almost $30 here after market hours, and now we're pulling back. If we go to the 1 day, 1 minute, we can see exactly where their shares are. They're roughly at about 29 or 28 rather, 93. So this pullback here, you know, could open up a position tomorrow. So let's say it does end up maintaining this level. I would love to see an entry at around 28.50, maybe 28.75 tomorrow for AMD on a potential swing trade. But again, I'm very happy that we're finally showing some direction here. And I was actually reading a couple of articles. Some analysts do actually think that AMD is going to hit all-time highs again. We saw a bunch of analysts raising their price targets a couple of weeks ago. So with that and you know, with the positive earnings report here from the brief metrics that I saw, you know, this could be a catalyst for AMD's growth. So AMD, definitely one that I'm watching. Obviously, Apple, don't have to go too in-depth on that because we really just did that. Hopefully, we get a pullback in Apple so I can get an entry point there. What's the other ones I wanted to talk about today? Google, guys, again, Google reported pretty bad earnings. They missed, I believe, on EPS and revenue, right? Their sales in terms of their cash cow business was, they were down, right? The sales were down. The stock tanked from nearly 1,300 down to about 1,188. But now with Apple's good earnings, I would love to see if Google's going to end up pumping back up, right? If we go to the 1 day, 1 minute, we're slowly starting to see a little pop-up here. We had consolidation pretty much all day today. And if we do get a confirmation back up into the 1200s, guys, that's going to be, in my eyes, the continuation of the uptrend here. And at that point, I'm heavily considering a position in Google. The uptrend's looking nice. We're maintaining a support, but I want to see what we're going to do over these next couple of days. I do have cash set aside. Again, I didn't trade today, right? I want to have cash, and if we do end up pumping back up, I'm going to be taking a position in Google, guys. So Google, Facebook, Apple, those are the three main ones that I'm watching here. We're seeing crude oil, you know, kind of getting rejected by that 50 simple moving average today, right? We also got rejected by this resistance at about 64.50. So ideally, if we break that level tomorrow in crude oil, I would love to take a position in UWT, which is at about $21.20 right now. It's looking like it's maintaining a higher low from the previous. Very good sign that we're continuing the uptrend. Just need to see that break above the resistance for crude oil. So guys, those are just a couple. This video, I wanted to just mostly focus on Apple, right? Let's throw some pot stocks here very quickly. You know, CGC, we haven't talked about that one in a while. This one's been roaring, right? It's breaking out of the resistance at $50. You know, this could potentially be a play. You know, Cron is slowly starting to reverse to the upside, right? Just keep an eye on this 180 SMA break. That can be a play as well. Again, this video was mostly for Apple and my plans in terms of that stock. So I'm going to end off the video right here, guys. If you enjoyed the video, feel free to go down below, hit that like button, subscribe to the channel if you're new, and hit that notification bell so you're notified every time that I do make a video. If you enjoyed this video, again, feel free to drop a comment. Let me know what you thought about it. What do you think about earnings? What do you think about the market right now? I would love to know. So I'll catch you guys in the next video. I hope you all have a great night. I hope you all did great today. Good luck tomorrow. Peace out. Have a good one. I'll catch you all in the next video.